as we told you, Mac Jones saw significantly more snaps this preseason than his counterpart. But here's something to keep in mind in the decision-making process. Mac pushed the ball downfield at a higher rate than Cam, even though Newton took an average more time to throw. So Cam's mobility proved effective, but he was not sacked once, while Mac Jones was sacked five times. Just depends on exactly what they're going to want here and what makes their offense run the best. There's a lot more to it, as Belichick alluded to. He always is making us guess. Adam, any sense on where the Patriots are in this decision here?
Look, Laura, let's look at the facts here. Mac Jones led eight drives this preseason. The Patriots scored a field goal or touchdown on all eight drives. He has been on the money, on point, and at some point in time here, it looks like Mac Jones' time is coming, probably sooner rather than later. It doesn't look like they've made a final decision as of yet, but clearly Mac Jones is competing, if not threatening, to take over that starting job sooner rather than later, whether that's week one, week three, week five. Look, Cam Newton may start the opener against the Miami Dolphins, may play well, they may win, and they may hold on to his job. But at this point, it seems like only a matter of time before at some point Mac Jones is going to get the ball in the starting job.
Cam has been outplayed by Mac Jones in this preseason. And if I'm going to hold the same that I hold based on what I saw Justin Fields do in Chicago and say that he should be the starter based off of a preseason and things that he did, it's the same that goes for Mac. Now listen, we talked about this before the draft, y'all. This was a perfect situation for Mac Jones to right. end up in New England, very familiar with what he did in college. They understand how he thrives and does well, and we understood that this was for the future. But here's where my shift in thinking came. I said Cam really didn't do anything to relinquish the starting spot leading into the season, but he didn't separate himself either. And I think that's what Bill Belichick was trying to see if it would materialize and take place. But Cam has not been bad in the preseason. There have been times where you question, like, does he still have what it takes in order for New England to be who they are? I just believe Mac Jones has outplayed him, Dan and MK, and that's why I think he should be the starter.
Yeah, and that's one of the reasons why we felt like the Patriots were doing everything they could in the offseason to surround Cam Newton or whoever would be the quarterback with so many weapons and options that they didn't have last season. Mina, are there any reservations about Mac Jones, though, at this point?
You know, Laura, Mac Jones has been spectacular in this preseason. I think he's shown everything the Patriots had hoped he would when they drafted him, in particular, the accuracy. I mean, the pass that Dan highlighted earlier, the back shoulder fade, was just so perfectly placed. Yeah. But you also saw, I think, in this last game, why there might be a slight reservation on Bill Belichick's part in throwing him to the Wolves right away. He did hold on to the football a little bit longer in this outing behind the second string offensive line, possibly due to some post-snap confusion as he was trying to process what the secondary was giving him. And he, as you saw at the beginning, took more sacks over the course of the entire preseason than Cam. This was the ding on him pre-draft, the athleticism, the ability to evade pressure. Now, again, I want to be clear. I think that's something that's not going to be a huge issue for him given where he's at mentally, the touch he throws with, the anticipation. But if I had to isolate one reason why Bill Belichick might be waiting a little bit longer than we'd like, I suspect that would be it.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.